Good morning, everyone. So today we will be discussing about this 2D DCT. So DCT stands for discrete cosine transform. Okay. Now the forward 2D DCT, it is given by V equals to C, where C stands for the transformation matrix, discrete cosine transformation matrix, multiplied by U, where U is our image in the spatial domain, multiplied by C transpose. That means transpose of the DCT matrix. Okay. Now this equation, it is used for 1D transformation. Okay, so basically what happens is that our DCT matrix is calculated using this formula alpha k. So it comes over here, alpha k multiplied by cos of pi into 2n plus 1 into k divided by 2n. Okay, now for a 2 by 2 DCT matrix, our n and our k values, n comma k values, it varies from 0 to 1. Okay, so for the calculation of this, we'll be making a 2 by 2 matrix, and over here we'll be varying, say n equals to 0, 1, and in the y axis it will be k equals to 0 and 1. Further, in any case, alpha 0 is equal to under root of 1 by n. In this case, capital N is equal to 2, so it will be under root of 1 by 2. Now, what happens over here is that for k equals to 0, that means all the values in this rows will be having a value of under root of 1 by 2. Okay? So let us write it down, under root of 1 by 2 and under root of 1 by 2, right? Next, for this cell, our n is equal to 0 and our k is equal to 1. So our alpha k, it will be under root of 2 by n, again 2. So this gets cancels out. So this becomes 1. So, right? Then, our this portion, it becomes cos of pi 2n. So, 2 multiplied by 0 is 0 plus 1. So, it becomes multiplied by 1 multiplied by, again, k is equal to 1. Divided by 2 into 2, 4. So it becomes cos of pi by 4. So our alpha k was 1 and this is again cos of 4. So cos pi by 4. So this box, it assumes the value of cos of pi by 4. Similarly, when we go to this last pixel, where n is equal to 1 and k is equal to 1, again this alpha value, k equals to 1, so it becomes 2 by under root of n, that means 1 again, and then this value, it becomes cos of pi into 2 into 1 plus 1, 3 multiplied by 1 by 4. So it becomes cos of 3 pi by 4. So this assumes the values of cos of 3 pi by 4. So you can calculate the values over here. Similarly, when we are deriving the 4 by 4 matrix, our 4 by 4 matrix, it assumes this value. Over here, we are having n equals to n values from 0, 1, 2, 3, and k varies from 0, 1, 2, 3 again. Now, when k equals to 0, our alpha 0, it will become 1 by 4, which is equals to 1 by 2. Okay, and in all these cases, since k equals to 0, we will get cos of 0, which is equal to 1. So multiplied by this one, so we get multiplied by half, so we get 0.5 in all the pixel values. Okay, then for the calculation of the other pixels, we will use alpha k equals to under root of 2 by 4, which is equals to under root of 1 by 2. So for k equals to 1, all these values, then k equals to 2, all these pixel values or these matrix values, we will consider alpha k equals to under root of 1 by 2, and we will change the values of n and k in this cost function, and subsequently we will get the values. So I have already calculated the value over here, and this is the matrix which we have got. Now for the calculation of the DCT image, what we have to do is that, as I already said you, that we have to multiply for calculating this DCT domain image or DCT transformed image V, we have to multiply C multiplied by our image U. So this is what I have done in the first step, DCT multiplied by image, and we have got the intermediate image. And then when I will multiply this V intermediate with transpose of the C matrix, which is the DCT transform matrix. So again over here, so we will be getting the DCT domain image. Again, for the calculation of U, that is to get back the original image from the transformed image, we will be going for a reverse transformation process. That means we will be multiplying CT with V and again then with C. Okay, so this is what I have done over here for calculating the inverse DCT. So U equals to CT multiplied by V multiplied by C, and I have calculated all these values. And consequently, if you see, after doing so, first I have multiplied with this DCT transpose with the transformed image, and I have got U intermediate. And then again with the U intermediate, when I multiplied with the DCT matrix, I got the original image. Okay, so this is how we can calculate the DCT matrix and how we can get into the DCT transformed image, and again back from the transformed image to the original spatial domain image. Now there are certain considerations over here which you would be needing if I give some numeric I give some this short note on DCT. First of all, it involves DCT involves real arithmetic for real valued data, and because of this reason it is simpler than FT, where FT has got conjugate numbers and we have to deal with the complex numbers, not conjugate. It is having the complex numbers and we have to deal with the complex multiplication and addition. Again, over here inverse kernel is identical to the forward kernel. This is another important thing. In the case of Fourier transform, we had to take the conjugate. Okay, so forward transform and the inverse transform, they were different. Then after transformation, dynamic range increases dynamically. Okay, if you look into here, into the DCT domain image, we have got 4 over here and all other values are 0. Right? So if you look into the image, it is a very highly correlated image, and DCT helps us in data compression, and we get only one significant number and rest are insignificant numbers. Again, in another example, if you see in this image, when we have done the DCT, this thing, we have got a significant number in the first pixel, 00 pixel, and the all other pixel values are not that significant. Okay, so because of this, there is a dynamic increase in the dynamic range increases dramatically, and then because of the reason already I have told, that only one pixel, 00 pixel, has got the significant digit and all other pixel values assumes very negligible value. So this helps us in high energy compaction. This is because few coefficients have large or significant values. So it is easier for us to store and transmit the data. So insignificant values can be removed by quantization process, which again helps us in reducing the data storage. And again, lastly, as I told you, it helps in lossy data compression, and it is mainly used in JPEG and MPEG compression. Okay, thank you very much. I hope you must have understood the concept of DCT. Thank you.